Hi, मैं हूँ श्रुति on my second nature. And today on EcoGiri, speaking to a fellow eco warrior. She's somebody जो मुंबई में cleanliness drives organize करती हैं, eco-friendly lifestyle promote करती हैं, and now in fact अपनी team के साथ उन्होंने launch किया है एक completely organic and eco-friendly product range ताकि आपके घर में chemicals के alternatives आ सकें. Who am I talking about? Well, from Prema Safe Earth. Today we are going to be speaking on EcoGiri with Radhika Dharmarajan. Hello Radhika, how are you?
Very well, thank you Shruti. Wonderful to talk to you.
Fantastic, I'm feeling amazing talking to you right now because aapke products main already, you know, I've called for them, I have used them, I have actually used it on my plants, I've used it in my house and the products are amazing. So
I'm so glad that you're loving it.
Yes, so I thought best cheez hai ki aapse baat karein and first let's get to know each other a little bit. And via me, of course, I'm pretty sure that my listeners will want to get to know you as well. So, sabse pehle, I want to know what was your tipping point? You know, usually kya hota hai ki jab bhi all of us are leading our normal lives and then we come to that one point in life when we say bas bahut ho gaya. अभी यू नो और कोई करे नहीं करे, आई नीड टू गो केमिकल फ्री, आई नीड टू स्टार्ट प्रमोटिंग दिस. सो व्हेन डिड दैट हैपन फॉर यू एंड व्हाई डिड इट हैपन? व्हाट ऐसा क्या हुआ लाइफ में दैट हैपन? टेल मी अबाउट दैट.
सो श्रुति, आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन इंक्लाइंड मोर टुवर्ड्स सस्टेनेबल लिविंग, इट्स लाइक ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्ट्स, एनवायरमेंटल फ्रीक, राइट, कंजर्वेशन, दीज आर ऑल अराउंड वर्ड्स अराउंड मी, माय लाइफ. But I spent time going to Bachpan se, like that's pretty conscious, and as a family also, more or less, I think we are all aligned around these values, right? So if you look at the places we travel also, you'll see a lot more jungles and mountains. So I think it's just more genetic and nature, that's how it is. But I would love to thank Corona, I know there's a lot of negative connotation to Corona, but this period has been really like an eye-opener. So much of time, so much of introspection, like every, like we just, it's like getting up in the morning and brushing teeth is like a ticking the box for being hygienic, right? Correct. Not thinking about what's going in, what are the products we are using, yeah, what's happening because of our hygiene, so many little things. Correct. I think my tipping point over this, I must thank this Corona period, because of the time that I got to see each and everything that's happening and how we are messing up so much. It was quite glaring on my face, I must say that.
Right.
Even like things that we just apply on our body, taking it for granted. Like skin being the largest organ, we're all conscious about what we eat, but not so conscious about what goes into our body through our skin,
so true,
through inhalation. Yeah. So all this put together, I think it was like a eye-opener, rather scary feeling.
I'm completely with you on that because the same thing happened to me. March, April, I think. And March, April is when I began realizing it. And by May, I remember that's when I completely went chemical free. I just said, that's it, I've had enough. May onwards, I'm going to be completely... So I started getting all reetha-weetha ka, you know, ghar pe kuch bana rahe hai baalon ke liye.
Exactly. House became a lab, I must say that. So March was the time when you started looking at all the labels, started finding ki kya cheez hai, I mean, what is it? Like, why are we doing this? Itna suna hai, pada hai. So I think just became more focused around it,
right,
and started looking at everything and also started looking at alternatives, because it's not like one day you decide I'm going to go chemical free and it happens.
Exactly.
It's a journey.
Yeah.
And also our body is used to chemicals. So suddenly body can't be devoid of it altogether, right?
Very true.
So I was like one product at a time. Even with my toothpaste, my journey was like, okay, I'm going to use an alternative, alternate days. I started that way.
Nice.
So one day toothpaste, one day, you know, I use this clove paste and sometimes charcoal. So the transition has been smooth.
Yeah.
And it's not, now I'm completely off it. So I'm confident that I won't go back to toothpaste. Yeah. Other than wo fear rehta hai, ye hua, nahi hua, is it clean, not clean?
Yeah,
That sort of stuff. Slowly, slowly, one thing at a time.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing what I am listening in from you and from my personal experience, what I've realized is, kabhi bhi, we can't treat this kind of a lifestyle as a, oh, try karke dekhte hain. आई थिंक इट्स समथिंग विच हैज टू बी अ प्रॉपर लाइफस्टाइल कि धीरे धीरे आप चेंजेस कर रहे हो एंड स्लोली यू गो टुवर्ड्स इट. इफ वन डे यू गो कोल्ड टर्की देन 100% यू विल फॉल बैक. सो वन शुडंट डू दैट. या ओके बट टेल मी इज दिस लाइक डू यू हैव लाइक अ डे जॉब एंड अ नाइट जॉब. आर यू लाइक यू नो स्वूपिंग द अर्थ सेविंग इट बाय नाइट एंड बाय डे व्हाट डू यू डू.
सो आई एम अ टीचर बाय प्रोफेशन. आई वर्क विद नेक्स्ट स्कूल. सो आई वर्क विद लॉट ऑफ यंग I would say youth and young kids, if we can seed these thoughts into them,
right.
And also being the person who believes in doing things than speaking a lot about it before doing it. So the kids in school also have seen this transition. Like my school is chemical free today. Can proudly say that. Yeah. And then so kids have also been seeing, and I've introduced this to them as well. Like this is something that you people can do it at home. And they being this young, who are so enthusiastic about everything.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, aise ho sakta hai, this can happen, that can happen. So trying to, infect the young minds, let me put it that way, and create awareness.
Please do that for us also. That's the whole point why I wanted to chat with you about it.
Yeah.
Because it is so necessary for all of us to get infected with this amazing, how to go eco-friendly and sustainable living and zero wastage culture.
Yes.
So, you are also someone, cleanliness drives bhi organize karte hain, right? Like couple of them you've tried to clean up the area around your house and stuff like that.
Yeah, so started with home, then building, then the place where I stay. So slowly trying to create awareness and increase the scope.
Right. So if somebody is listening to us right now thinking, yaar, ye kyon kar rahe hain ye log? Like, if they are just wondering or they're wondering how to do it. So according to you, what will be the step-by-step way? Ki sabse pehle kis cheez se shuru karein and then what should they do and then what to do?
So if it's for personal journey, I would say start with your waste, right? Because we have loads of them at home.
Correct.
And when you start looking, I think the best thing to start with is a waste audit. Ghar mein kachre ke dabbe mein jata kya hai? Let's get there. Start there first.
Correct.
And it'll be fascinating to see, hey, but why is this here? Why is this going into the dustbin? Can it find a better place? And I think just crossing some places in Mumbai, like Kanjurmarg and all those places, if you see the piles of garbage just on the Eastern Express Highway, it is a freaking scary sight to see. You're like, are the hills taller or the garbage piles taller? I mean, the reason why we need to do it also, because we need fresh air to breathe or also clean water to drink. These are basic things that we have to be aware of. So I think dustbin is a great place to begin with at home. Just if you are conscious or do a waste audit at home as to what goes in, what is the frequency, what are the things that we can stop from reaching the dustbin, or is there an alternate place where it can go? I think that's where I would say, let's get started.
Correct. So is composting at home difficult or easy for you?
For me, today I can say it's super easy and it is super, super, super addictive. You really want to let go of the green waste. And koi dal raha hai toh, I'm literally like a hawk. Like, mat dalo yaar, mujhe de do. That's thought of aaya.
Right. Correct. Yeah. But how difficult is it? Because mostly sabko lagta hai ki, it might smell. Or, where to get it started? Because, in this urban living culture, ghar toh chote-chote hain. Toh, where to then begin doing all this, So, what are your tips for that?
So, it is a myth. Should be ki ghar chota hai, baas marta hai, it smells dirty. If done right, koi problem nahi hai. So I have it in my house just next to my dining table, and I use that drum as like a stand for my plants. So wouldn't even know that that's where I'm composting, sort of. So, but again, it is an art and a science. I wouldn't say that you're going to just get it right. Or you might get it right also, or it'll go wrong. So you just have to keep getting better at it.
Right.
But it is no rocket science at all to start composting.
Correct.
What you just need first is the intention and motivation. But motivation aa bhi jayega when you get started, when you know the cause as to why you need to do it. I think naturally you will get to do it. So what you need is a drum or a bucket that to recycle. Don't go for anything new. If you have a terracotta pot at home, use that. Or if you have any plastic ka dabba which is lying waste, use that. Just properly make sure that you have drilled holes into them because aerobic composting is much easier. So you can get started with that. And you can start with things at home. Waste to hai, because everybody eats some form of sabji or food gets wasted. Ya kharab ho jata hai food. So waste ka to, there is no shortage of supply.
I want to go a little deeper into this. You just said, there is aerobics composting. So what all types are there?
Primarily, there are three types. One is aerobic composting, where you use that oxygen from the air to break down the organic waste. Easiest form. Then you also have anaerobic composting, which is also called bokashi composting. That's a methodology. Again, that's also not difficult, because you just have to put the right mix, and it is without air. So it's a closed container. It has a tap also where your lichen can flow out, sort of, you know.
Right,
so that's also not a problem. And third one is vermicomposting. So I don't do vermicomposting. Again, space and all that. But I do aerobic composting, which is pretty easy. And I've been successful, and that black gold is something that my plants look forward to, my gardens look forward to.
So I have no idea what composting I'm doing from these three. All I do is I just layer it up. I just put a little purana mitti niche, then I put dry leaves, then I put all my kachra, and then I just keep repeating this layered
holes,
thing.
I mean, you have holes in the container, right?
Not really. Like, I haven't even been doing that, and still lots of it. Like, it gets done within 20 days or so. I have
that's
lots
anaerobic
of nice.
And you have good stuff happening. So perfect.
Oh, good.
So it's all of balance. You know, it's like how you're going to balance the brown and the green. Let me put it that way. Dry and the wet. So the browns are something that comes from soil, or you can add cocoa peat. Or you can add compost, which is partially ready. Cardboard, apna itna Amazon se sab cardboard aata
rehta hai.
Just keep collecting that. Tear, use it. Dry leaves, they are brilliant.
So that's what I do. I do jhadu in the, you know, where all the plants are, and all the leaves that I ikattha karo, those go into my composting as the dry thing for it.
Perfect.
So,
perfect.
That way. So, so now let me ask you this. Ke ye sare options, you know, we keep finding, we keep growing, we keep going deeper into the whole thing about zero wastage and about being eco-friendly. But what is the biggest problem that you have come across so far?
If we try to go zero waste, you will be like, waste hi nahi hona chahiye. That is next to impossible.
Correct.
So, is zero waste a possible thing to do? I'm really not sure about that today, because I have not been able to go zero waste. But definitely, making modifications in the way you live, the way you purchase, the way you sort things, or the way you look at garbage, it will lead you to reduce waste to a drastic extent. So I think to begin with, that's the goal. Because you look at small things, like you go to buy your grocery. I still take my cloth bags and my bottles and everything and go. But there are few things like oil. He'll tell you, either take the can, or if I need to buy 1 or 2 liter, it'll be in that plastic bag only. Much ever you try, unless I go to that oil mill where I can take my
But in everyday life, it's very impossible to think that, you know, you have to go out of your way to go do that. But in everyday, you know, it's not possible every now and then to constantly be that proper
it's
about zero.
Challenging, but then if it's like over weekend, you have to plan your, for example, kitchen, grocery list, so that you take all these utensils. There are small logistical issues that you will face in a city like Bombay, like udhar parking nahi milega. So how will you take all these dabbas and go? These are small day-to-day things that, but slowly working around it, getting better at it, I would say. So if I plan that, okay, this is today, I'm going to spend my day figuring out oil so that I take the containers, go to the oil mill, pick it up. So it will be conscious work towards it. It can't happen overnight. But the biggest challenge is small thing. Then you'll have some Amazon parcel coming in, or a Flipkart parcel. That will have a plastic wrapper. Definitely can be reused.
Or the plastic sellotape.
Yes, the tape. That is impossible to reuse. So then where does that go?
Correct.
Small things that way.
And then the guilt that follows, because then you're like, how do you deal with it? How do you deal with the guilt?
So initially I should be like, I should go zero waste. I can't have plastics at all at home. But plastic is a boon and a bane. That's something that I've come to terms with. So, and I figured out another thing, that you don't have to get rid of all the plastic at home. till the time there's life to it, keep reusing it, reusing it, reusing it. Because to recycle also, there it consumes a lot of energy and resources. So that itself is another big process, right? We say recycle karo, but what at what cost are we recycling? That is something. I'm not talking about money alone. In terms of resource, in terms of the environmental impact also, what's going on? So repurpose, reuse. I think that's the mantra. And if we can avoid getting it in our house, nothing like it. So there are multiple steps to it.
Right.
Yeah.
So according to you, if today, you know, you had a live audience who were ready and willing to listen and to do what you're talking about.
Yes.
In that case, what is the one or maybe two things that you would like to tell them that, okay, and they all already follow this kind of a lifestyle. You know,
yes.
Everybody's already trying to grow things. They're growing things at home. They're taking care of it. Plastic kam kar rahe hain. Sab kuch kar rahe hain. To those people, what is the one or two things that you would like to say?
If they are composting, I would say inspect more and more people to do this, because barely the percentage of people who are living this lifestyle is very, 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 very skewed. So I think just keep, you know, educating, talk about it, show people that it's possible. It really doesn't consume a lot of your time. You still can do your day job or do everything that you do, but live this lifestyle. Another thing I would say is something which I consciously practice is I have a toolkit which has a straw, spoon, you know, a glass, a plate, which is always there in the bag these days. That also, wherever you're going, if you take it along, I think it consciously spreads a very strong message. Initially, it will be like, oh, but then when people see that there is a reason why she's bringing her own glass, why she's bringing her own plate instead of using... I'm talking about when you travel, when you go outside, when they give you those paper plates, paper cups, which is the biggest myth that it is paper, because paper cups are not paper. It's plastic, right? And
Upar se dikhta paper hai, but then if you really begin to play with it and tear it apart, you realize that there's a layer of plastic.
Because paper can't hold liquid. So
it is
plastic. So small thing. These are two things that I would say. Just talk loud about the work that you're doing. Because more and more people need to get into this for our planet, and so that we have a better space to live. And I think each one to their capacity. That's the best mantra.
Nobody has to become perfect immediately. Dheere dheere, baby steps. I think we all need to do that one thing, and so that we can get better.
Now
I want to talk about Prema Safe Earth. So when did you, I believe you very recently began the product range, right? So what was the idea behind it? Who all are in it? How does it go?
So Prema Safe Earth again happened during this lockdown. So I've been using these products for some time at home. And all around my family, people have been also using it. We've been testing, trying how effective it is.
So because, what all are these products?
Okay, so we have a floor cleaner, a toilet cleaner. We have a compost. Then we have a all-purpose cleaner. So for your clothes, kitchen, everything that you need in the house.
Everyday, household
stuff. Yes, everyday. Household stuff to keep your house clean. That's what we have introduced now. And slowly, we'll see what more to get into the sustainable living. That's the idea.
Yeah, I can already tell you, toothpaste. Please,
yes.
add toothpaste to your list.
Definitely.
Because I think I've ordered everything else. I just need a toothpaste also from you now.
I also attended a workshop where I figured out, Shruti, that, you know, like Datun, any green stem, okay, except couple of them, if we chew on them, it's great for our gums. And it's also a great mouth freshener. I mean, just because you spoke about toothpaste, but
so
yes, that's also my journey.
I know neem I already use.
No,
but
we generally
else?
Use neem, but any flowering plant ka stem, like rose also, if you remove the thorns, you can actually chew on it. Yeah.
So you mean like if I take, I have a lemon plant growing, I have mint growing, I have like, so I can actually just pull it out and just... What?
Absolutely.
I'm definitely going to try this. This is super cool.
Yes, we can do that.
Nice. Now, if people need to connect with you and to find, you know, your products and everything, where all are they available? How do we, you know, reach out to you on social media? Please give us your details.
Sure. So on Instagram, we are available. So it's active. So Dream, it's like Prema Safe Earth. That's one space you can find us. And also something that I want to mention about is the way we package. So we try and not package our products with cardboard, and the mode of delivery is also by in person. so that we can avoid packaging as much as we can. And the bottles are repurposed. So we get it from all the beer bars around or kabaddi walas around. And we sort of sanitize them, clean them, use a bioenzyme to sanitize these bottles also.
Wow.
So, yeah, we've just being conscious about everything, because if we are introducing product, we shouldn't add to the waste on our planet.
100%. And also, if you won't follow it while giving your product, then it's like, you know, one of those things where you're not following what you're preaching. So, which is so wonderful. So, and I also know that the people who come and deliver, they are also people who are currently, you know, who either lost their jobs during COVID or who are the husbands or the wives of the people who work at the school, right?
That's right. So, like for them also, it becomes an income where they are, they have their own scooter or however they want to commute. They are happy to do it. Some extra income for them. And also, I can see the enthusiasm in the people who work at our residences, because they have seen how these products are made. So, first testing lab was our own homes. We wanted to be really sure about, you know, what we are using. Will we use it before we send it to someone else, right? Otherwise,
very important.
It's like hypocrisy, I would say. Then immediate friends and family. Then we launched a product to the market. So I'm convinced in terms of even my house help and all, they take it. They're like, Didi, we want to use this. We want to try this. Bahut clean hota hai, saaf hota hai. So at every stage, because we buy toilet cleaners, but they are the people who are cleaning our toilet. So it's their health which is at stake more than our health, because they are using their hands with bleaching powder or whatever, which is absolutely not okay. So, and inhaling those fumes.
I've noticed that change. I've noticed ever since I've gone chemical free, I mean, after the initial 15 days where my hands felt very dry because they were so used to chemicals that they took a while to change. But after 15 days, after that, suddenly my everything was very naturally moisturized. I didn't need to do anything. And as long as I was using the natural products, it remained like that. You know, so I know what you're talking about. I've practically experienced it. So yes, it completely works, and we must be conscientious about this. So thank you so much for having such a wonderful chat with me. And of course, you can also follow Radhika Dharmarajan as eco_warrior_Radhika, right?
Yes, that's right.
Yes. It was so amazing chatting with you. And I hope lots and lots and lots of more people join the cause, and lots of more people can buy your product.
Thanks for that. Thoda thoda, small steps, because it's a very purpose-driven mission. And the whole family is involved. Yes. It's like, along with me, it's my brother, my sister-in-law, another cousin. So it's all driven by like-minded family at the moment, and very, very careful about what we want to offer and how we want to offer.
This is so wonderful. It's such a pleasure to talk to you and to talk to someone who's following this so dearly. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shruti.
Bye.
Yeah, thanks so much. Bye-bye.
That's all from me, Shruti, on My Second Nature today. So, EcoGiri ka aaj ka episode aapko kaisa laga? You can zarur go and find Instagram pe EcoGiri, and wahan pe aap mujhe bata sakte hain. Details sari jo Prema Safe Earth and Radhika Dharmarajan ki hain, wo write-up mein likhi bhi hui hain, so you can connect with her via that as well. Chaliye, main nikalti hun phir. I will see you next time right here on My Second Nature.